Sure, it's red dot.
It's red dot.
We're pulling in.
Mm-hmm. Pulling in. There's a house. There's lake. There's a big house.
Oh my god.
Mm-hmm. We're the upper here. One. And there we go.
Oh, this is awesome.
For your time and effort.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
I appreciate
it. Much appreciated.
You're welcome.
How's it going?
Good. How are you?
See, all the photographs that Netflix supplied and everything.
That is amazing. Oops.
Is that the Lattimore's treasure?
Yes. These were painted by a local artist, and my aunt bought the originals.
Oh, geez. Okay. Looks nice.
Well, that's the Latin
Bible, yeah.
It's so much bigger in person.
Is it?
It does.
It seems bigger on TV to me. Huh? I grew up, like, here all the time. Right. We had parties and everything. So I've been here all my life.
Just a thing.
Is this the boy's room?
Yeah, I'll come back there.
Alright. Can I get through that way?
Or?
Oh, you want me to move the chair?
Yes. Just
over.
Thank you.
Can you get through there?
So I saw in your video this used to actually be a pond or something. Fish pond?
When I was growing up, there was water in here, and it was like an indoor-outdoor aquarium.
Right.
And, and you would think, you know, you'd have a nice koi or something like that. No, they would catch bass and trout and put them in here.
Oh, that's funny.
And when I was growing up, you can see the difference in the floor right here.
Yeah.
There was a wall right here.
Oh, okay. I see it right there.
And then there was it was like a garden, a terrarium, I guess you would call it.
Uh-huh.
Wow. The actors and actresses, do they still keep in contact with you? Or
not really. I mean, they. I communicate with Skylar, which is Jonah.
Oh.
Oh, okay.
My uncle owned a cat, and his name was Fat Cat. In fact, there's a picture of Skylar with Fat Cat.
Oh, I see.
And. Fat Cat died not too long ago, and I contacted Skylar and let him know, and he was upset. Because he really dug it. They always had to put, when they were shooting, they had to put Fat Cat in a cage because Laura Linney is
allergic,
wildly allergic.
Oh, wow.
So they would have to come in here and clean profusely because the cat lived here.
Yeah.
No one lives in this house.
Let me scoot by you. This is beautiful.
I appreciate it. Again, we appreciate it. Thank you.
Absolutely.
So, did any of the other actors and actresses, they say, hi, how are you doing, or get the heck out of my way?
No, everybody was really super nice. Jason Bateman played poker with my uncle.
Wow.
I mean, I would come down here, and Jason Bateman would be walking around. How it started is that my aunt and uncle got a letter that was stuck in their door, and it was from Netflix, and it was just a note, and my aunt said, this is a letter from Netflix, so my uncle threw it in the trash. So my aunt got it out of the trash, opened it up and read it, and said, let's just call them and see what they want. So the showrunner and the director of the first episode wanted to come down here and look. Well, the director of the first episode was Jason Baker. So, they're walking around here, they start, my aunt and uncle started realizing, hey, this is a big thing, because Jason Bateman was walking around the property. And so he was walking around, and Jason Bateman was like freaking out. He was like, this is it. This is it. I want this. And the showrunner's like, shh, we haven't negotiated anything yet. So it went on from there. But they agreed to do that. The house directly across the street, which also is owned by my aunt and uncle, was the real estate agent's house or office. If you remember in the first season, she gets hit by a garbage truck.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
That happened right there at the end of that road. I was here that day. And you can see it in the, my aunt and uncle's last name is Bailey. And that road right there is named Bailey Road.
Okay.
And you can see it on the TV show when she gets hit. You can see the sign, Bailey Road.
I remember that one.
That's outrageous.
Hey, let me call you back, okay? All right.
How long were they just doing production here, like, every day, every week, just for a few hours?
Well, they did it for 4 years.
Right.
Sometimes it's sporadic. There was a lot of stuff shot here. It was maybe 5-6 months a year. So it was that.
That's the window that
They shot all the
what's his name? Buddy.
Buddy.
Yeah, Buddy shot.
Buddy shot that one out, but no, but Jonas shot all these. All these were replaced.
They really shot the windows?
Oh yeah, over and over and over again.
Holy cow.
Really?
Yeah, whichever way you want to come, I'll walk through here if you want to go this way. If you've got enough room, I'll take you back here to the...
I believe this was Jonas's room.
This was Jonas's room.
Okay.
And like I said, nothing's changed. Even the sheets are the same.
Oh, goodness.
I wanted them to buy everything. This is Jonah's toys that they had.
This is amazing. Like a time capsule.
Mm-hmm. Feel free to walk around in there.
Wow.
Famous...
the hallway.
Yeah, the famous where they go down into the Buddy's
cool
room.
I'll show you where Buddy's, show you the basement.
Okay.
Now, this is a bathroom, a Jack and Jill bathroom, but they never used it because you can't.
Is that the one that the bedroom just linked into?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah, there it is.
And this is Charlotte's room.
Wow.
And like I said, everything's the same. Sheets, everything.
How often are we going to come in here and clean up this?
I think they have somebody come in here, and no one lives here.
Right.
But they have a cleaning crew come in here once a week.
They do a good job.
No. This is awesome.
I mean, take your time. Don't let me rush you.
I'm just doing the video, and then I'll come back with pictures.
Because what I'm going to do is I'll take you on a tour of the thing, and then we'll go in there, and I've got a video documentary about the house.
Okay, awesome.
And this is the bathroom. This is a functioning bathroom, and they've never used the actual bathroom. That bathroom that they used in the TV show is in Norcross in a studio.
Okay. Is that also where they take the Missouri Bell is not there anymore?
No,
is that...
it's on Lake Allatoona, I think.
Before I leave, can I get that address or name or whatever from you?
It's online. I had to look it up.
Okay. Because we went there and they're filming something for Disney. We couldn't even get close to it.
I think the Memphis Bell is gone.
Well, it's not there anymore.
Yeah.
At Stone Mountain.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You've had quite a few scenes in this room, too.
Mm-hmm. And you could see the bathroom, like, there, from this angle, but you never...
Okay, yeah.
And I don't know what my aunt did with it, but I got all of Wendy's makeup and toothbrush and all that
stuff. Oh, wow, she got it all.
Yeah.
Oh, well, yeah, I remember her from Congo.
Oh, she was nominated for an Academy Award.
Yeah, I remember her in that one movie, Congo.
I just saw where Skyler, the guy that played Noah, uh-huh. is in another Fox TV show.
Is he? Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Very cool.
Is this supposed to come out soon?
I think it's already started. Okay. I can't remember what the name of it is. I just saw. And I'm in negotiations with the guy. He made two. I need him to make another one. And that's the cookie jar.
The goat.
Oh, yeah.
I want a cookie jar to put in the kitchen.
Yes.
That'd be awesome.
That was a goat one, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. That would be
because it would
the
be
cherry
really cool
on top.
To have it.
They only made two?
Yep. And Jason Bateman has one, and the showrunner's got the other.
Okay. How about that? They didn't do anything upstairs, right?
They shot one scene.
They did?
In the first season.
But it wasn't here. The house on the show didn't have an upstairs, did it?
Yes.
It did?
Yeah, you always saw the stairs.
Oh, yeah, I guess you're right, yeah. I just didn't see any rooms or anything up there.
And this is the garage. This is where Marty had his stuff. His computers and all that stuff.
Oh. And Buddy's beloved basement.
And this is where you go down to the basement.
Right here.
Right.
You want to go down there?
I've seen it. I know.
Go ahead and go down. Oh, you already know the secret.
I saw your video.
You see the bar?
I do.
There's a bar.
Oh, my gosh.
Like you can go downstairs.
Is this a light?
Oh, how about that?
Yeah.
To what?
Next door. No, oh. I actually don't know. So
that's where Buddy's room was.
Yeah, I guess the lights burned out.
Okay.
But it, of course, goes to nowhere. There's a hot water heater right there.
That is so cool that there's a handrail.
It's hidden.
Maybe I can get in here a little bit. That is so cool.
But I guess maybe a year ago, time just has gone by. About a year ago, a guy contacted me from Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
He said, hey, I'm a real fan. And I've spent a lot of money on Ozark. And I said, well, yeah, okay. A lot of people have, sure. No, he bought the dress that...
Ruth?
That Ruth was shot in.
Oh, wow.
Well, that
one. He bought the sofa that her...
That was outside?
No, that was...
Oh, the Lattimore's, they'd sit on... Yeah.
No, they were shot on.
Oh, Darlene and Wyatt.
He was down in the basement.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Blood all over it.
Oh, gosh.
Darlene and... what's his name?
Wyatt.
Yeah.
And there used to be a arcade game that's sitting right there.
Yes, I remember.
He owns that. He bought safe that...
How do you even go about doing that as a fan?
He went to Duluth, and that's where the studio was.
Oh, okay.
And
worked it out.
And they were auctioning it off.
Oh, lucky.
He spent like $6,000 on the dress.
Oh,
so he's a real
fan. He's serious.
So he got here and he brought me Kentucky whiskey and all kinds of stuff. So he was really nice. He knew that I was a big Jaws fan, and he brought me some autograph stuff from people that were in Jaws.
Cool.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt obligated, and I let him spend the night.
Oh, that is too cool.
Nice.
So I stayed here, too, because we hit that Kentucky
whiskey in the bar.
I don't know.
So I didn't go anywhere.
Wow.
But like I said, yeah.
Whoops, excuse me.
You guys can that's kind of the tour. I'll put on that documentary thing. It's a little short.
And so much.
So how are you all in weather out here? Y'all still have our fishing?
This is the back of the house. Now we'll walk down to the dock. And this is where they had the memorial for Ben, or Wendy did. We're on the dock from the show. As you can see, we got looky-loos. There's the house. Right here is where there was another dock adjacent to it, where they found the dead body. This is really rocky. Beautiful.
House is probably one of my favorite locations to film at.
The Byrd House has been a central location for us. All the different plot points that have ended up weaving through here.
It became a character unto itself.
It is kind of another family member, you know?
Stunningly beautiful. I mean, it is beautiful.
The beauty of that location is those windows and that lake.
This house has been amazing for us. It kind of told us what it needed to be. It sort of delivered us a look of Ozark as much as we sought it out. It kind of found us.
Like a good 90% of my scenes have been here.
Not gonna get emotional. Here we go. Wait a minute. Here it comes. Not doing it. The first day I was on set, I showed up at this house.
Yeah, there's a hint in the arcade.
Yeah.
So, when anyone says to me Ozark, that's what flashes in my mind. It's the Byrd House.
Honestly, really kind of bizarre. This is like one of the last times I'm actually gonna walk through this place. I've been here since I was like 12 or 13 or something. Let's take a look. These pictures, I think those were on our first day, actually, the whole Byrd family getting together at the studio to take these pictures. When they're like, hey, you get a little bit closer, a little bit closer. That was when I really realized that it's gonna be a really good group of people to be working with.
I think my first scene here was the yellow taxi cab scene with Laura.
Mom, what are we doing here? Your father's laundering money for a Mexican drug cartel.
It's like become our home in a way, and now, 5 years later, it's not going to be anymore. This house has always been constant and been consistent in the story. It signifies their unity and their togetherness as a family.
The Byrd House definitely has sort of become a character in the show, the way it was initially introduced. It was like literally attached to Buddy.
Who is that?
That is Buddy Diker.
We're all dying the minute we're born. Goes fast. Don't waste it.
There's been a lot of really pivotal things that have gone down right in this area. A big scene from season one was when Navarro's hitman, Garcia, came in. I came in that door with the gun that I had gotten from Tuck.
Stay back!
But Buddy had taken out the ammo from the gun, and he came in with a shotgun of his own.
You need to share your tamale hole.
Sort of saved him from having to have that moment. Being here definitely reminds me of Buddy walking down to the lake to go skinny dipping. That's definitely one of the most iconic moments where you just kind of realize the absurdity of everything that's going on. And it's cool how that was parallel with Ben when he runs down to the lake. The Byrd House has been sort of tainted by different events that have happened, and eventually the Byrd parents kind of turn it into more of a prison for the kids.
I need to know where both of you are every second of every day. You understand that?
Also, like prisoners.
So at the point after he finds out that Ben was ultimately killed because of his mom's decision, and he blasts a hole in the windows. That blowing out of the windows is sort of a representation of wanting to escape that prison.
Why? Why shoot? What is that?
I was upset because mom killed Ben.
It's not that simple.
Here, of course, is the kitchen. This is where I feel like Jonah ends up grabbing snacks.
Cool.
It kind of stinks in there because this isn't actually on.
They replaced the refrigerator.
Okay.
And here is the messy garage. Oh, there's a bird in here, too. So this is where Marty had his famous money laundering 101 speech. Jonah is kind of, you can tell he's developing an interest for it.
Could you explain all of it?
Okay.
And that's kind of the precursor to now coming into season 4. I'm not using your software, I wrote my own.
Jesus, laundering at 14.
Do not be proud of him right now.
Over here is my room. It's definitely some mixed feelings coming towards the end of this experience. It's ending, and that's sad for everyone, for the viewers, for us. We've, you know, come to have so many good relationships for cast and crew alike. But on the other hand, we achieved what we wanted to. We're happy with what we have. All right. Definitely gonna miss this view.
It all was ending tomorrow, and it is, it's like saying goodbye, honestly. It's like when a character dies or when somebody picture wraps or something, they're gonna say, you know, that's a wrap on the birdhouse, and I think we're all gonna be pretty emotional over it.
Think for yourself.
Okay, that's enough. Because I think you're being childish. How about that?
Oh, I'm being childish.
Yeah.
Well, I am not listening to your foolishness anymore. La,
are you really doing
la,
this right now?
La, 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 la.
Mom, get out of here!
Sue? It's Marty.
Bobby Dean for Jacob.
Thank you. Go ahead, take it down.
Thanks.
I don't understand.
Yeah, well, you know, it's the zoning issues that we were talking about. I'm pissed off, too.
Well, what exactly is the issue?
The specific issue.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's, boy, it's complicated. It's,
That much cash money is ill-gotten. We got as much right to it as he does.
No, you do not. That is my money and I've taken it. Relax. Relax. Just tell me one thing, okay? What do you think you're gonna do with all of that cash? Can't you stick it there?
Ruth Langmore?
Lawyer.
Oh, no, you don't. Then I'd have to arrest you.
For what?
How about a double murder, for starters? You know, I just gotta ask you, what forces do you think you're messing with when a double murder's the least of your problems?
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
Oh, no? How about the Navarro cartel? Ring any kind of a bell? Listen carefully, because you have three options here. Turn states, right now, end up in a cute little Arizona ranch house with $800 a month for doing absolutely nothing. How does that sound?
Sounds like go fuck yourself.
Clever.
Were you drinking too?
No. I wouldn't.
Oh, good. So it was just the pot and the guns then.
Charlotte, I've got a question. Why didn't you leave? You had a van.
Aaron wouldn't leave.
Okay. You can't make
Wendy.
Your own.
A word.
In my car. Now.
Can I ride with you, Dad?
Oh, you should go in your mom's car, okay?
Why?
It's okay. We're having a.
A thing. Here we go.
What kind of thing?
In my car. Now.
Marty?
Yeah, I'm still here.
I just checked. It's not us.
Well, who the fuck is it then?
I don't know, but it's not us. Where are you exactly?
I'm out in front of a dollar store in a mini mall corner of Hawk Nest and Parkway.
Through a back door?
There's an alleyway, so there must be.
Go inside. In 5 minutes, Nelson will pick you up and take you home.
Okay, but right now I'm not living at home.
You are tonight.
These are good.
They are.
And pancakes for dinner reminds me of the house on Fire Pink Road.
The bats.
The bats.
It was a great house.
Was it?
I had that big front porch.
I did. That was Lucky's porch.
It was.
Oh, he was such a good boy.
There you go.
Good morning.
Hey, the gas tank is filled.
That's a waste.
Why is that?
Simple economics, all supply, no demand.
Don't worry about that.
What do you do?